compensation. Now, in Workday, we have two types of compensation modules. One is core compensation, one is advanced compensation. So here we will be only talking about core compensation module. So this is a specific module. Okay, compensation is not, it is part of core HCM, but it has got its own importance. But if at all we take advanced compensation, that is outside your core HCM. Okay, that has again separate functionality about it. Now, what we generally do in this compensation? In this compensation, generally what we define here in this particular part is whenever we are hiring anybody, okay, even in India, like whenever we are hiring any person, we will just decide, okay, what is the grade that we have to give to that person? Okay, so grades are again defined by your organization policies. If a person is having 0 to 2 years of experience, give him grade 1. 2 to 3 years, grade 2, 3 to 4 years, grade 3, something like that. So your company is going to put a policy on it. Okay. So we always maintain every organization have grades, and we also have something like grade profiles. That means for grade 1, what is the range of salary that we are giving, whether it is like 0 to 3 lakhs per annum. So that can be given to a fresher. If he performs very good, 3 lakhs. If he performs on an average basis, 2 lakhs. It all depends. So again, every grade profile is linked to your grade, where grade profile always deals with your salary ranges. Okay. And then we again have something like package, compensation package structure, where we try to include everything. And then we also have something like your compensation plans. So for example, any employee is hiring, any employee, we are hiring any employee, then we'll say whether we are paying him on annual basis or hourly basis. If you take US market, mostly it's hourly basis. And then they basically do it on weekly or bi-weekly basis. But in India, it's like annually we will show them the package, but we generally pay him on monthly basis, right? So here we will define something like salary plans, and then we will see how that employee, what is the package that is offered to that employee on annual basis. So here in compensation, we are just showing that how much the employee is paid. If at all the employee has to really get paid, that is again maintained in your Workday payroll module. Here we are not paying an employee. We are just showing that how much employee is holding as part of his compensation package. Okay. Again, we have some rules and all. Let's say if at all there is something like car allowance plan. So only directors in the organization should get it, not everybody. Then again, we can write a rule. Okay. If there is something like festival bonus, then only managers in the organization should get it. Again, we can write a rule. So there is something called as compensation eligibility rules, where we can use those rules and write up, and then we can assign it to our package so that only those people who are part of that particular category will get these plans. Okay. All right, that's about your compensation. Next is with your security. Security is again kind of an very global kind of an concepts that we are going to discuss, where once you understand the concept here, you go to any module, you implement any other module like Workday payroll, Workday absence, Workday time tracking, any other module, it's the same. Concepts are the same for your security. So security is also going to be very, very critical, because you know, like we all know, like even when we are working for any companies, if we need to enter into our company premises or anything, we have to swipe in, swipe out for every room, for servers room, there's again a kind of a security. So that way we can relate that in Workday also, security has been placed in every area. What employee has to actually see, what employee can actually do. So these two are the different category. Okay, with this, we have some domain policies. We have some business process policies. Domain policies is always deals with the data. Who can see what data? For example, if my client says that I don't want managers to see the compensation part of any employee, irrespective of whether they are subordinates or any other. So for that, we can always restrict. So we can go with your domain security policies, and we can make sure that the managers in the organization are restricted to see the employees' compensation details. Okay. In the same way, anybody who is hired in the organization, only like compensation partners are allowed to give the compensation. Not everybody is allowed to give the compensation to an employee, only compensation partner is a role. Then again, we have something like business process security policies, where we go and then we add permissions to that process so that only compensation partners are going to do it. Okay. And again, it's kind of an ocean, where security is an ocean, where we have different business security types like job based, role based, user based. So we will see everything. But whatever is required for our training, we will see, because we have almost like 10 types of security groups, which we don't see all security groups, where there are very complex level of security groups, whatever is frequently used and whatever is important. So we are going to discuss some 5 types of security groups in these kind of sessions, so that once you are, you know, like how this can be used, and once you are placed in a project, you can go and easily read the guides or anything, if at all you have to implement the other type of security groups. Okay, so we will all discuss about those security groups.